Welcome students, today we are going to discuss about the behavior of the some electrical element, that is the linear element, that is the resistance, inductance, the resistor, inductor and capacitor in a AC circuit. That is, if the resistor or inductor or capacitor is connected in across a AC source, voltage source, then what is the behavior, that is the what is the current equation for that, what is the waveform, what is the phasor diagram, what is the phase, what is the impedance, what is the power factor, what is the power, all these things we have to discuss in this video. So let's start. So first of all, we start our topic with the resistor, that is, write down behavior of a pure resistor in AC circuit, that is, draw a pure resistor, that is R, which is connected across a voltage source, and the voltage source must be the alternating in nature, that is the AC. Then what is the behavior of this, that resistance over it? Okay, so you can take it as R. So the applied voltage is V. It is nothing but the Vm sin omega t, where omega t is nothing but the phase. This is the phase and this is the peak value of the voltage, peak value of the alternating voltage. So due to that, you can say that I current will flow through this resistor, and due to that a voltage drop is there across the resistor. That is nothing but the, you can say it as a VR, that is a voltage drop across R is the VR. Now we can discuss about the parameters, that is, we want to measure. Okay, so first is current. What is the behavior of current? So we know that the applied voltage is V is equal to Vm sin omega t. With respect to the Vm sin omega t, we find what is the expression for the current. So we know from Ohm's law, we know that I is equal to, that is, V by R, the applied voltage by R. Here V is the Vm sin omega t, that is alternating in nature, by R. So we can write it as the Vm by R into sin omega t. So Vm by R is nothing but the, we can say it as Im sin omega t, where omega t is the, again it is a phase, and it is nothing but a peak value of the alternating current. So the applied voltage is Vm sin omega t, and we are getting I as Im sin omega t. So they all are the, in the nature of the current and voltage are same. That is, that it's clear that the current is in phase with the voltage in a pure resistive circuit. So current, you can note it, that current is in phase with the applied voltage in a pure resistor. Pure is the keyword, because if it is a pure, then this only happen if there is some inductive or capacitive part associated with the resistor, then the behavior must be changed, and that we will discuss in our next video. There is the RLC circuit. Okay, now discuss about the waveforms. So here the current and voltage are in the same phase. So if you draw the current and voltage phasor, then if this is the voltage phasor, voltage waveform, that is the V is equal to Vm sin omega t, then what will be the waveform for the current? So the current waveforms would be like this. So this is nothing but the I is equal to Im sin omega t. As they are in the same phase, so they are up and down, that is the phase, the shifting in the negative, that is the alternation of the current and voltage are simultaneous to each other. It is when the current is maximum, at that time the voltage is maximum. When the current is zero, at that time voltage is zero, like this. So this is nothing but the theta axis. Okay, so this is the waveform. Now we can, this is the second part. First part is the current and the third part is the phasor diagram. What will be the phasor diagram? If you say this is a V, that is a reference phasor, so if there is no phase difference between the, there is no angle between the voltage and current, so you can say that the in the pure resistor the voltage and current are in the same phase. So if this is the voltage phasor, then the current phasor should be in the same phase with the voltage. So this may be treated as the current phasor I. Okay, so the current and voltage are in the same phase. I and V are in same phase because there is no leading or lagging angle between the voltage and current. So this one is the third part. Now the fourth part is the, you can calculate impedance. Impedance is nothing but the resistance over here. So the, what is the impedance? So it is the resistance offered to flow the current in an AC circuit. That there is some existence of the resistance which can offer to flow the current. Means if that value is high, then the current which is flow through this circuit is less, and if the resistance part is high, then the current is less. So the impedance is denoted by Z is equal to nothing but the V by I, because it is nothing but the resistive part, and R is equal to, from Ohm's law we know that it is a V by I. So it is the Vm by Im, because sin omega t we can cancel it. So we can write Vm by R, can be written as Vm by R is I, nothing, it is nothing but the R. So here Z is nothing but the R, that is the resistive part of the circuit, the resistance of the circuit, nothing but the impedance over here. Now what is the power factor? Okay, let me explain another thing. There is the phase angle or the phase difference. As the voltage and current are in same phase, I and V are in same phase, so the phase difference is, so the phase difference is, you know, it is denoted by phi, nothing but the 0 degree. Okay, this is the phase difference in a pure resistive circuit. Now we can calculate the power factor. Calculate the power factor. What is the power factor? Power factor is defined as the cosine of the angle between the voltage and current phasor. It is the cosine of the angle between I and V phasor. So here you see that the angle between the V and I is 0, that is the phase difference is 0 degree. Here you see that phase difference is 0 degree. So cosine of that angle, so cos of 0 degree, you see, you know that the cos 0 is 1. So the power factor in pure resistive circuit is nothing but the 1. Okay. Now you can calculate the power. What is the expression for power? So you can first calculate the instantaneous power, then average power. So instantaneous power. So we know that a simple equation P is equal to V into I. It is what? Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t. So we can write it as Vm into Im sin square omega t. So we can say that if it is divided by, if we divide Vm Im by 2, then it becomes 2 sin square omega theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta, theta is over 1 by omega t. That is the Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 into cos 2 omega t. So here you see that power in the expression of power is nothing but the Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 cos 2 omega t. Okay, that is, it is a what kind of part? It is a constant part, because Vm and Im both are the constant. But if you consider this part, this is nothing but a fluctuating part. As cos is associate, so it is nothing but a alternating in nature. So cos curve is like this, so alternating in nature. So it is fluctuating. Once it is in the positive half cycle, then it is negative half cycle, then again positive half cycle, like this. It is fluctuating part. So, and the frequency of the fluctuating part power is twice of the applied voltage frequency. So, and its average value over a complete cycle is zero. So if as it is a cosine curve, so you can say that if it is a complete cycle, then you can say that this part and this part will cancel out. So this part we can consider it as a zero. Okay, so what is the net power? That is the average power. The average power is what? Vm Im by 2. Okay, so we can write it, this expression, as Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. Okay, that is the V into I. You can say it Vm by root 2 is the V and Im by root 2 is the I. So here it is nothing but so you see in the previous slide that the waveform of voltage and current are in the same phase. So if as average power is nothing but the multiplication of the voltage and current. So this is a voltage waveform, and this is, and you can say that this is a current waveform. So if you, so this is a voltage waveform, this is a current waveform. So you can multiply these two, we get what kind of expression? The expression, the what kind of graph? The graph is like this. Because if you multiply these two, then these two magnitude can be multiplied and we get a higher magnitude than the voltage or current. And as this positive part and positive part, if you multiply, then you get positive part, and the negative voltage part and the negative current part, if you multiply, then you also get the positive negative V, and the negative I will give you the positive P. So here these two, if you multiply this V and I, you get the two the graph, the waveform like this. So you can say it as a P average, and it is nothing but the theta, this is pi, this is 2 pi, like this. Okay, so this is the expression for power. So this is all about the behavior of a resistor in a AC circuit. Now we can consider a behavior of a pure inductor in AC circuit. So you can write the heading behavior of pure inductor in a AC circuit. Okay, so again we can connect one L across, L is inductor, across a alternating voltage. You connect one inductor across a pure inductor across a alternating voltage source. Okay, so this is your circuit diagram, this is your voltage source V, is nothing but the Vm sin omega t, this is nothing but the L over here. Okay, so this is the VL voltage drop across this inductor. Now I can explain it in two way. One is, first you calculate the current. Current equation. Okay. So what is the current equation? So we know that I is equal to 1 by L integration of V dt. This is the current expression for inductor. So in the place of V, we can write it integration of Vm sin omega t dt. Okay. So if you integrate it, so omega is a constant and Vm is also a constant. Vm is the maximum value or peak value of the alternating voltage by omega L integration of sine, sorry, taking Vm and omega outside, in the integration of sine theta d theta is nothing but the minus of cos omega t. Okay, now we can write it as Vm by omega L sine of omega t minus pi by 2, sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. As there is minus, then omega t become plus and 90 degree becomes minus. So sine omega t minus pi by 2. So Vm by omega, we can write it as Im sine omega t minus pi by 2. This is the current expression. What was the voltage expression given, applied voltage? So applied voltage is nothing but the Vm sin omega t. What is the current equation? It is nothing but the I is equal to, this is the Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, so how omega Vm by omega L is nothing but the Im, that I can explain. Okay, so in this circuit, if we say that the energy is E over here, the energy is E over here, then we can, and we apply, if we apply KVL over here, then we can say that in the second process I am explaining, here I can explain it, you can say that V minus E is equal to 0, and the what is the energy expression? V minus L di by dt, this is the energy expression, energy stored in inductor, V minus L di by dt is equal to 0. Okay, so L di by dt is nothing but the V, so we can say di is equal to V by L into dt. Okay, now in the place of V we can say di is equal to V naught sin omega t by L into dt. Now we can integrate both side. If you integrate both side, di is equal to integration of V zero, V naught sin omega t by L. Instead of Vm, I am taking V naught because this is the second process. So, sin V naught sin omega t dt. Okay. So, integration of di is the I. Now, V naught by L is constant. You can take it outside. So, integration of sin omega t is become minus of cos omega t. And here omega is there by omega. This is the expression. So we can write here, from here we can write I is equal to I is equal to V naught minus of V naught by L. This is the minus, minus V naught by L or omega L cos omega t. We can write it. Okay, so if, and if current is denoted by I naught sin omega t or cos omega t, I may be sin function or may be cos function, because or cos or sin both are the alternating in nature. If the alternating voltage is applied, then due to that alternating voltage we are getting the alternating current. So we can say that the expression of I become I naught cos omega t. So if you compare these two, then I naught is nothing but the, we can take it as I is equal to minus I naught. So I naught may be is nothing but the V naught by omega L. Okay, V naught by omega L, is it? So V naught by omega L is the I naught, or here Im or I naught, Im or I naught are the same. That's why Vm by omega L is written as Im or I naught, whatever it is. Okay, so this is the current expression for it. So now waveform. Here waveform. So see it minutely. So the voltage expression is V is equal to Vm sin omega t. It means that it is a theta. So we can say the voltage waveform is like this. The voltage waveform is like this. So here it is a pi. It is a 2 pi, it is a pi by 2. Okay, now we can take write pi by 2 down. Okay, now the current is here, which one is leading or which one is lagging, means current is lagging behind pi by 2, means when voltage reaches maximum value, at that times current starts to grow. So we can say that at that time when the voltage is maximum, at that time the current starts growing and it becomes and it grow like this. So if this is the I is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. I have already told you that I have already discussed in the previous class. So this is the pi by 2. So if the voltage, if this is pi by 2, it means that this waveform is lagging behind the voltage. It means that when the voltage is maximum, reaches maximum value, maximum Vm, at that time the current starts growing. So this is the voltage or current waveform over here. So you can write it as this one is the V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Okay, so this is the waveform. Now you see the phasor diagram. So give the heading phasor diagram. So you take V as reference phasor. You can take V as reference phasor, draw the V. This is the V. So if V is the phasor, a difference phasor, then and current is B is the nothing but the minus 90 degree with the V. If clockwise gives you the plus, then anti-clock and so if anti-clockwise give you the positive value, then clockwise gives you the negative value. So if this is V, so this may be I. Or I have already told you that there are two phasors. The phasors are like this. So which one is leading or which one is lagging? How can you understand? So first is you stay outside the phasor and rotate the entire phasor anti-clockwise, which meets you first, that is the leading in nature. Here it is V, it is I, you can tell, you can take. So you just rotate the entire phasor anticlockwise and you see that I will meet you first. It means that in these two diagram, I is leading in nature with V. So if it is V, and another way and another process, that is, or you stay inside the phasor and you rotate anticlockwise, which come meets you first, that is a leading in nature. Here you stay inside V and I, and you rotate anticlockwise and you meets I first, so I is leading in nature. So here you see that this is V and this is I. So you stay outside the phasor and rotate the phasor anticlockwise, you see that V is leading in nature, and from the previous graph, it is a previous waveform, it is also clear that the V is starts before I, means when V reaches the maximum value, at that time current is starts growing. So there is also V leads with current. So one very important conclusion is that in pure inductor, V leads by 90 degree with I, or we can say I lag behind 90 degree with V. This is the very important aspect from this AC part. Okay, so phasor part is there. So now calculate the impedance. So Z is equal to nothing but the V by I, is nothing but the Vm by Im. Okay, and in the previous discussion we have already proved that Im is nothing but the Vm by omega L. So you can put Vm by omega L over there, then you get only omega L. That is the, this is nothing but the, you can express it as XL. That is the, it is written as inductive reactance. It is nothing but the same thing. That is the that is the resistance part of which is present in the inductor. So the quantity omega L is called the inductive reactance and is denoted by XL. And it is, its unit is also obviously ohm is its unit, as it is nothing but the same as the resistance. Okay, so for DC supply, so one extra thing I am discussing, it is important for the fabrication of the filters. It is very much needed. If DC is applied, then that is the FDC, the frequency of DC is zero. So XL is what? Omega L, or you can read 2 pi FL. So it is nothing but the, if you put F is equal to zero, then the XL becomes zero. XL is zero, it means that the resistive part is equal to zero. So we can say that an inductor acts as a short circuit for a DC supply. Means if you apply DC to a inductor, the inductor becomes short circuit. If this is inductor and if you apply DC, then this circuit becomes like this, a short circuit. Okay, the resistance part is the zero. So this is the impedance part. So what is the phase difference? You can calculate the phase difference. What is the phase difference? It is the angle between the voltage and current phasor. Angle between V and I phasor. So what is the angle between the V and I phasor? So it is the 90 degree. You should take the minimum angle when you consider a phasor. You should take a minimum angle. You can tell that the phasor, set the angle between this V and I is the 270 degree. And if you take it as 270 degree, then you can say that I is lead from VI by 270 degree, but it is not that, because in a phasor, if there is angle, it means that it makes two angle. One is interior angle and another is the reflex angle or the exterior angle. If it is 90 degree, then the reflex angle of the 90 degree is 270 degree. Okay, 270 degree. So if it is 270 degrees, so you can tell that, sir, I is lead from V by 270 degree. No, it is not, because we have to consider the smaller angle. That is the, here it is the smaller angle between the V and I is 90 degree. So the angle between the V and I phasor is nothing but the, is phi is equal to 90 degree. Now easily you can calculate the power factor part. There is a power factor. Power factor is nothing but the cosine angle between the voltage and current phasor. That is the cos of 90 degree is the power factor. Power factor is denoted by PF is equal to cos phi is nothing but the zero. So the power factor of a pure inductor, if we apply AC through it, then it becomes zero. Now what is the power? So here we also calculate the instantaneous power. it is obviously denoted by P is equal to V into I is nothing but the Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. The current expression is Im sin omega t minus pi by 2 and the voltage expression is Vm sin omega t. So it becomes, we can take this outside, so it becomes minus Vm Im sin omega t and sin omega t minus sin pi by 2 minus omega. It becomes, if we take minus common, then it becomes sin pi by 2 minus omega t. So sin pi by 2 minus omega t is nothing but the cos omega t. Okay, so if we divide it by my 2, say Vm Im by 2 into, it becomes 2 sin omega t cos omega t. So what is the expression for 2 sin omega t cos omega t? It becomes sin 2 omega t. This is the power expression. So here you see that the expression is obviously a fluctuating part. Only fluctuating part is there. So you can draw the phasor diagram for this, not phasor diagram, the waveform of the power. So if it is a power, this is the x and y axis. If this is theta, this is power. As it is a pure sinusoid, then, and there is a minus before it. So if this is 0 degree, so this is Vm Im by 2 and sin 2 omega t is there. So 2 omega t is, as 2 omega t is there, so it is nothing but the pi by 2 is the pi. This is the 3 pi by 2 and this is the 2 pi. 3 pi by 2, this is the 2 pi. So as it start, it has a negative value minus before the expression, so the sinusoid will start from here and go like this. This is the waveform for power. Okay, here, and you see that the average value of the power, a complete cycle, is 0. So the average value of power for one complete cycle is 0. If this is a one complete cycle, then this part and this part is cancel out, so it becomes 0. So the most important conclusion is that the power consumed by a pure inductive circuit is 0. So we cannot, the inductor cannot consume any power if it put across a AC, and if a inductor is put across a DC, then it behaves as a short circuit. So this is all about the inductor. Now we start the capacitor, behavior of a pure capacitor in a AC circuit. So write down the heading. Behavior of a pure capacitor in AC circuit. Okay, so again you have to draw one capacitive circuit. So take a white color
So
here this is a capacitor. There is a positive plate and negative plate, and obviously one alternating voltage source is connected across the capacitor. So this is the alternating voltage source. So it is V is equal to Vm sin omega t, and due to that I current is flowing through it. This is the capacitor. The voltage drop across capacitor is Vc. You can take it as Vc. So what is the same thing we have to derive? What is the current expression? Okay. So let's start the calculating the current expression. Current. So applied voltage is Vm sin omega t, and due to that you have to find out what amount of current is flowing through it. So the alternating current is given by the capacitor. The alternating current is I is equal to C dv by dt. Okay, so you can write it as C d dt of Vm sin omega t, as V is the Vm sin omega t. So you can take it inside the bracket. So it is, so omega C Vm cos omega t. Vm and C is the common, and sin omega t, the as omega is a constant, so the derivative of the sin omega t becomes cos omega t becomes sin omega t becomes cos omega t. So you can write it as omega C Vm sin omega t plus 90. Theta plus 90 is equal to cos theta. Okay, so it is written as Im sin omega t plus 90 degree, as Im is equal to omega C into Vm. In the same way as the previous, we can prove that the Im into omega is nothing but the omega C into Vm is nothing but the Im. So we can take it as, so here you can say that plus Q charge is accumulate in this plate, plus Q, and here minus Q charge is accumulate, minus Q. Okay, so if you apply the KVL over here, so you can write that V minus Q by C is equal to 0. Okay, that Q by C, V minus Q by C is equal to 0. So V is equal to Q by C, or it is a famous expression, Q is equal to CV. This is the expression for the charge into a capacitor. Okay, so Q can be written as is equal to C V naught sin omega t, as V is the Vm sin omega t, V naught sin omega t. In the next process, it is the second process, so taking Im or Vm as V naught or I naught. Okay, so we know that I is equal to what? I is equal to, we say, dq by dt. The rate of change of flow of charge with respect to time is the nothing but the current, is the d dt of C V naught sin omega t. Okay, so it is nothing but the C V naught cos ओमेगा टी इंटू ओमेगा। ओके सो वी कैन राइट इट एज आई इज इक्वल टू सी वी नॉट ओमेगा कॉस ओमेगा टी। सो the d dt of sin omega t is becoming the cos omega t into omega, so it becomes omega c v naught cos omega t. So if the standard equation for current is equal to I naught cos omega t, then we can compare these two and we get that I naught is nothing but the c v naught into omega. That c v naught or vm into omega is written as im or I naught. Okay, that's why I am replacing this omega c vm by im. Okay, now here easily we can calculate the impedance part also. See, I naught is equal to or im is equal to omega c vm. Again, I am going to discuss this thing in the two different way. So I naught is equal to what? V by 1 by omega c. This line can be written as v by 1 by omega c. So you know that v by r is equal to I, so or you can say v by v naught by r is equal to I. So if you compare this equation and this equation, then you can say that r is nothing but 1 by omega c, and it is nothing but the xc, that is the capacitive reactance, that is the resistive part which is present over there. So we can write 1 by omega c as 1 by 2 pi f c. Omega is nothing but the 2 pi f. In the another way we can prove it. Okay, that is, write down the impedance. Impedance, again impedance is nothing but the resistive part, it is denoted by Z. Z is equal to what? V by I is nothing but the Vm by Im. Vm is what? Vm is Vm. And I have already proved that Im is omega c into Vm, that is we can cancel out this Vm, then we get 1 by omega c. This is denoted by the xc, that is the capacitive reactance. Okay, so again make one note for DC supply, for DC. So what happened for DC? So if DC you know is equal to 0, that is the frequency of DC is 0. So if FDC is 0, so 1 by omega c can be written as 1 by 2 pi FC. So as F is 0, then it becomes 1 by 0, that is the XC. It is nothing but the XC. So what is the value of XC? XC becomes infinite. So if XC is infinite, means the resistive part, the resistance offered by a capacitor, if it put across a DC source, it is infinite. That is the resistive part of a capacitor, if it put across a DC, is much higher. It means that no current will flow through the capacitor if it put across a DC supply. So you can make one note, the capacitor acts as a open circuit in DC. this is very much important for electrical and electronic students. Okay, now waveform. Now waveform. What is the waveform? So write down the expression of the voltage and current. So applied voltage V is equal to Vm sin omega t, and current is I, is become Im sin omega t plus 90 degree. In the previous case, that is the in the case of inductor, I was Im sin omega t minus 90 degree, and I have told that the in that inductor case the current lags behind voltage by 90 degree. Here you see that the current is omega t plus 90, so the current is lead from the voltage at an angle of 90 degree, means when the current reaches maximum, then the voltage is starts growing. In the inductor case, I have told that when voltage grows maximum, then the current starts growing. Here it is the opposite of the inductor. So here you see the waveform. So you can see that V is the Vm sin omega t. So V starts for 0, V is equal to Vm sin omega t. If it is 0, this is pi, this is 2 pi like this. Okay, so this is pi by 2, this is 3 pi by 2, this is pi by 2, this is 3 pi by 2 like this. So if you draw the current waveform, then current waveform is like this. This is the I is equal to Im, capital I, Im sin omega t plus 90 degree, and this is nothing but the 90 degree or pi by 2. So you clearly see that when current reaches its maximum value, at that time V starts increasing. So here you see that, say that current is lead by 90 degree with the voltage. So what will be the phasor diagram? So if you take V as reference phasor, then current is lead by 90 degree. So how we can say that current is lead by 90 degree? So if this is the I, then you can say that this is 90 degree. Then you say that here current is lead by 90 degree with the voltage. Just check it. You stay outside the phasor and rotate the phasor anticlockwise. You see that current meets you first. It means that current is leading in nature. And in these two above equation, you see that current leads by 90 degree with the voltage. So impedance part, phasor diagram part, waveform part, and circuit and the current part is over. Now what is the phase difference? What is the phase difference? So heading phase difference. So it is the angle, the phasor angle between the voltage and current. So angle between I and V phasor. So here you see that the angle between V and I phasor is 90 degree. So the phase difference phi is nothing but the 90 degree. From it you can calculate the power factor also. So put the heading power factor. What is the power factor? Power factor is nothing but the denoted by PF, is nothing but the cos of phase difference, cosine angle of phase difference phi. Here phi is 90 degree, that is the cos of 90 degree. Again cos 90, we know it is the 0. The power factor of the capacitor across a capacitor is nothing but the 0. Then the last part, that is the power. Okay, again we have to calculate the instantaneous power. So instantaneous power is denoted by what? P is equal to V into I. What is the expression of V? Vm sin omega t. What is the expression for I? Im sin omega t plus pi by 2 or 90 degree. So it becomes Vm Im sin omega t cos omega t. Okay, so it becomes Vm Im by 2 sin 2 omega t. So 2, taking 2 as a denominator, it becomes 2 sin omega t cos omega t, that is the 2 sin theta cos theta. So 2 sin theta cos theta becomes sin 2 theta. So instantaneous power here, it is also the in this expression we see that it is a fluctuating power. So you see that if you draw the graph for power, then it is obviously a sine curve. If it is 0, then it is pi by 2 pi, then 3 pi by 2 2 pi, like this. This is a theta and this is the instantaneous power P. So the waveform should be like this. This is a waveform for the power. So you clearly see that the average value, average power of a full cycle, complete cycle, is 0. This part positive and negative part cancel out each other, this positive part and negative part cancel out each other. So P average for a complete cycle in capacitor across a AC source is 0. So power, so you can write that power consumed by a purely capacitive circuit is 0, and if you apply DC, then the capacitor or capacitive circuit is behave like a open circuit. So this is all about the R, L and C if they put across a AC source. Now in the next class we'll discuss about the mixed combination of this electrical component, that is the RL, RC, RLC, all these things. Okay, so in the next class you will prepare to study about the combination of the RL, RC and RLC, and for that to know it better you have to go through this video once, two and more times, as it is very much clear how that the resistor, inductor and capacitor behaves in a AC circuit. Okay, see you in the next class. Bye.